Consistency. Consistency is huge whenever you're trying to become something, become better at something, master a skill, hone a craft. But consistency is also very difficult, especially if you're the type of person who has stories or you get in your head or you doubt yourself. And it's very easy to fall into a pattern of incomplete consistency. You'll start doing something for a couple of days and then you stop. You start again and then you stop. You stop, you start again, and then you stop. And you essentially never complete the cycle. And I'm like that too, because I used to be like that, let's say. I can be very spotty in my consistency. And I'm still like that in a lot of ways. But when it comes to approaching, that was the one thing I got really consistent with. And in approaching, or in being consistent with approaching, I started to see that you can get really good at this stuff really fast, and it doesn't need to take a long time. So I was like you guys, maybe going out 1 or 2 days in a week, and then I wouldn't go out for maybe another couple of days, and I pick up again, do another 3 days, then wouldn't go out for a week and a half, and then wouldn't go out for another day or something like that, right? It was a bad pattern, and I was doing this. I was wondering like, yo, why am I not getting good at this stuff, and why am I not getting the girls that I want? Like, I understand everything Brian's teaching, but I'm not having the results. And so it really dawned on me after I had gone out and been more consistent that, oh, consistency is the problem here. It's not that I don't know what he's talking about. It's not that I don't get the concepts of grounding, creating a bubble, connecting, leading, being more masculine. It's that I'm not putting myself in an environment long enough to have that transmute into success. And what happened was, it wasn't until I did my last week long in Bucharest that I started to have so much success with women. I had so many sexual experiences when I was out there. I started dating some of the hottest girls I've ever dated in my life when I was out there. And when I came back to LA, the one thing that was on my mind was, I want to do this every day and I don't want to break the consistency that I had when I was out in Bucharest. So when I came back to LA, the first thing I did was I quit my job. And then I went out to Third Street Promenade, which is our place where we go out and meet girls because it's very local to us. Now, you guys might have a place in New York City, Walmart. I'm joking about Walmart, but in some places, Walmart is the mall for you guys in small towns. Or you guys have shopping centers, plazas, outlets, places where everybody goes, malls, for instance, beaches. So places in your city like that, that actually have the bulk of the women going out in those areas. And so I would do that. I would go out every day and I would approach. And so there was a period of time where I went out every day for 3 weeks straight. And within that first week, I had so many experiences that I was like, what the hell is going on? I'm dating girls, or I'm having insta dates. I had 5 insta dates in one day. I'm being a little bit more risky, and when I say my approaches are a lot more solid, girls are laughing, I'm making out with random girls here and there, I'm getting frisky with girls that I meet walking along shopping. Like, crazy stuff like that was happening because I was being consistent. Now, I want to talk to you guys in this video about the things that I did in order to get me out of my bed and off of my couch, out into the real world in those environments where I can actually approach, because I know it can be very difficult when your stories arise. I can't do this. What's the point? Why do I want to go out there and put myself in the face of rejection? Rejection hurts. Girls don't want to stop from me. Girls don't like me. And you have all these stories coming up and they can beat you down. They used to beat me down too, so I understand exactly where you're at. So before we jump into that, guys, it's very vital that you hit like and subscribe, not for our sake, but for your sake. When I used to work at the library, man, I would drive to work in the morning in traffic and I would have Brian playing in my speakers. When I would go to work, I would have Brian in my iPhone headphones. When I leave work going to the gym, I had Brian in my speakers again. When I came back from the gym, I had Brian in my speakers again. It was constantly, constantly, constantly talking to me. What was he doing? Well, he was really making believable what I didn't think I could actually have, which was dating upward, dating girls that I actually thought were completely beautiful. Because up until that point, I didn't believe that. I was taking the low-hanging fruit. I was dating girls that I really wasn't sexually interested in or even physically, but they were there and it was easy. So this stuff really primes your mind if you just let it run in the background. So hitting like and subscribe gives us a chance to put those videos out to you so that you can just hit play, Let them run in the background while you're working so that the stuff starts to seep into your subconscious. And what it does is it grows you a lot faster. I found out that it made me a lot more prone or inclined to stop and talk to people I saw in passing. Girls who might have glanced at me or gave me the eye, I would go over there and I'd talk to them. Because I had been listening to the stuff a lot and my body was ready to actually go out and have the physical experience of it instead of just hearing it over and over. So guys, do yourself a favor and hit play, but also hit like and subscribe so you guys can grow a lot faster than you're growing right now. Now, let's jump into the topic. The first 3 days were the hardest. The first 3 days before I jumped into this nonstop every single day for 3 weeks straight of going out and approaching like a monster, the first 3 days were the hardest. Because the first 3 days I was getting rejected left and right. The first 3 days I wasn't getting any numbers. The first day it was like starting a cold motor. The juices weren't flowing. I wasn't hitting, I wasn't in flow. And so on that fourth day, I didn't want to go out. My stories came up. They were like, you keep going to the same venues, Anthony, they're going to see you. Security's going to see you. The store clerks are going to see you. People are going to know you're out there and you look very desperate. And I started to feel personally needy because I was out there trying to get sex or trying to get girls. And so my stories about that started to come up. Oh, I felt like a predator and all this stuff, right? And these stories were coming up and it made me not want to go out. And so I had a choice to make. It was like either I stay there and I lay in bed and do what I had been doing, which was just scrolling Instagram, looking at porn, or I get up and go out and be in my discomfort. Now, obviously comfort always feels more appetizing, right? But truthfully, after going out for that 3 weeks straight, I can tell you guys that it's actually more fun to actually go out and be in your discomfort or in your uncomfort or in your uncertainties. Just because you don't know what's on the other side of that doesn't mean that it's something negative or something bad. And that's the problem. A lot of guys tap into that negativity where it's like, if I go out today, I'm not gonna get a girl, I'm gonna get rejected. And you're not even tapping into the potential that today can be an awesome day. Today can be the day that I get a girl. Because we're not thinking that way, we create that reality, we go out and then we have that expectation and we get exactly what we're expecting. So on that fourth day, it was the hardest for me. I remember thinking like, damn, this is my pattern. I do 3 days, I stop for a week. I do 3 days, I stop for a month. This is my pattern. And these are the voices that are always coming up. And this is what makes me stop all the time. I'm gonna get in my car and I'm gonna drive down the 3rd Street Promenade and I'm gonna go out for the day. But as soon as I got on the freeway, those voices start to come up again. What's the point? You're not good at this. Girls are rejecting you left and right. Security's gonna be called on you. People are seeing you out there. You're looking weird. You're looking like a predator. I get off the freeway. I take the street instead of the freeway. And as I'm going down the street, those thoughts are getting louder and louder and louder. And at some point they just break. And I get to the venue. And I'm out there at 3rd Street Promenade. And there I am. I put myself out there. I'm not in the bed anymore. And so my body wanted to all of a sudden stop people and ask for time and directions. Very low tension stuff. And we'll get into that in a second. But the fact that I was out there put me in a place where when that kicked on, I was already there and I can just start. And so if you guys are struggling with getting out the house, be very unconventional and just get up. Get away from the computer, get off the couch, get out of bed, get in your car, get on the bus, have your friend take you, have your mom take you, have your dad take you down to a place where all the girls are, where all the people are. Where are the bulk of the people in your city? Is it the mall? Is it Walmart? Is it the movie theater? Is it a plaza that's down there somewhere that's popping and banging? Is it a bar? Is it a club? Something like that where people are just hanging out. Get yourself in the environment. You don't have to pressure yourself to do anything, but get out there and give yourself a shot to be in a place where the potential could actually occur. Now, this is the second part here. This is the part that brought it all together. So I was out there and I wasn't necessarily going for the hardest stuff because I knew I wasn't ready for it. What I started to do was I started to do very low tension stuff, very low tension, like asking people for time, asking for people for the directions, or just saying hi to people in passing. Why was I doing that? Well, because my nervous system was nervous around people, was scared to stop and bother people. But I knew that people didn't mind stopping and answering my questions about time and directions. I can get people to stop and answer those questions. And so after doing about 5, 10 of those, maybe even 20, 25 sometimes, hell, even 100 if I wanted to, my nervous system will relax. And then when it came to looking at cute girls or girls I was actually interested in, they seemed a lot less threatening after I had did those stops with random people. And then from there, I was able to go up and ask girls that I was interested in for time and directions until I was confident enough to be like, hey, you're really cute. All right, I like your smile. Something flirtatious, something a little bit more forward. And the minute I started doing that, I did one or two of them, the tension will rise in my body. I had to sit down a little bit, release a little bit. I would, and then I would go back to doing indirect openers again until I can relax again. And then once I was relaxed again, I would start approaching girls who were cute and I would start talking to them. And then the tension of it all would start to decrease and decrease more over time. And then this is where I got a chance to practice the eye contact, creating a container between me and the girl, creating a bubble so that it was just me and her in this bubble, having this connection, having this moment. Me grounding my own body and not pushing my energy on her or trying to get or take, but just relaxing and enjoying myself. Me really receiving her, letting her in, right? Letting her beauty in, letting it affect me in my body so that it can give me the words that I need in order to connect with this girl a little bit deeper, all right? Or make this an interesting conversation. So again, I started very small. When you guys are going out there, don't try to take on the whole enchilada. Don't try to go out there and talk to the girl that's 8, 9, 10. Go out and start small, work your way up, give your body a chance to relax and unwind and warm up. And then step into a little bit more tension by asking girls that you are interested in low tension questions that they don't mind answering so that you can get your body in front of them enough to relax. All right, guys, very simple stuff, but highly effective. Like again, in that first week of the 3 weeks alone, I was making out with girls. I was going on Insta dates. I was getting physical with girls. I was taking girls back to my car. And there were a lot of different things going on. And I was just like, who is this guy? Like, I don't even know myself right now. But all I know is I'm having fun and I know they're having fun. And things that weren't happening before are happening now. So I want you guys to have those experiences. That's why you guys are here. That's why you guys are watching these videos in the first place. So it's time for you to go out and have those experiences. Remember guys, you only get one life. Don't settle. There's no reason to settle when you can be having what you guys want. I guarantee you, you guys can have what you want. Anyways, guys, pleasure shooting these videos for you. Remember, only the confident really live. Peace.